Hi Cancer, this is your November forecast. If you'd like a private reading with me or hypnosis to facilitate permanent change, do use the link below. Don't forget, Cancer, that on the 30th of this month, there is another eclipse and you will be affected by that. And also, this has been a really tiring time for a lot of people, but you might feel like you're being a bit emotional, a bit up and down and extra tired as well with what the energy that is going around. So as a whole, I'm looking at this and there is a major arcana here, card here asking you that you are in a place in your life where there needs to be a karmic change. You need to have the courage and face your fears where it comes to being emotionally open to the offer that is there around you. Now, the woman or the male in your life is a Scorpio, Pisces, or a Cancer, combination sun, moon, or rising. And this person is drawing out that nurturing and vulnerability within you. And what we're worried about here is this fear of commitment. Now you're laying there dreaming, thinking, obsessed about this person that's in your life, and you're unable to stop that constant thought where it comes to this relationship that's there. So what is extended out to you is an apology or an offer to be able to move things forward, or even saying yes when it comes there for that. When it comes to your career study in finance, it looks like that you have been moving forward and doing well, but there's been a bit of stagnant there. So the tide comes out, comes in, comes out, comes in, comes out. So it's a bit wavy up and down. So where we're looking at that right now, it is about feeling protected in our job environment, worrying about what it looks like in the future. It looks like you have a person there, your boss or someone higher than you, who is really able to clear that fogginess, give some clear answers on why this is doing that, giving you some information to make things better, to make the more abundance there. And it's time for you to be able to, so emotionally you're involved in this and it's carrying you too far away. What you need to do is put that down and bring yourself back to shore and walk straight up forward, and you'll find that that is the path to least resistance and better results. When it comes to your home, we do have the Four of Swords. Now, I am a Cancer myself, and I've been stuck in bed, exhaustion, migraines, I've got a brain tumor, so lots of seizures, all those sorts of things. So this card is definitely signifying being laid up where it comes to pins and needles, any kind of migraines, any of the things that I just said. But also, there is this laying about, unable to sleep, insomnia, about constant emotional, thinking, obsessive thoughts, not being able to switch it off. So during this month, Cancer, it's really good for you to be able to be near water, no shoes on the ground, because you are a Cancer and you need this nature around you. A bath with lots of salt in it, a bit of rose water, rose quartz around you as well, and plenty of hydration as well. Looks like somewhere in your family you're worried about somebody, and you're worried about your home as well. Some of you are worried about protecting your home. There's also the idea of I want to be able to change what my future looks like, or I want to start being able to move forward to moving my home or moving in with somebody else or getting onto the next leg of what my life wants to look like, well, or what I want my life to look like. But this month is going to go back and forth, back and forth. And don't forget, November the 30th eclipse is going to hide not all the details, but you're not going to know everything. It's just going to take its time. Again, another date to look at is the 20th, 21st of December. There's a swift change of power there. When it comes to your health, we do have the Strength card. Look, this is a major arcana card. It is karmic, and it's talking about the eighth house, which is bladder, genital, sex organs, reproductive system, hemorrhoids, muscular system, hernias, rectum, and prostate. But this is also about trauma. So when you put these two together, this issue here of being insomniac and that constant obsessive thinking and these thoughts that are sharp in our mind, and it can be about our family, it can be about our home, because it is a four card, but this swords, it is about your thinking. And this card here is about trauma and healing of the mind. So you might find that this is a pattern that you've had before, and this is a time now to get rid of that insomnia, get rid of this obsessive. This is anxiety, stress, and depression. There is a wave of nausea and stillness and not being able to move, feeling laid up. So to calm those thoughts and for you to be able to move forward, it's time now for you to actually accept that there are things about you in your past that you need to acknowledge, release, and permanently release and move forward. forward. So good month for hypnosis. If you want to use the link below and book in with me, this is a really good time, especially with these eclipses going on, for you to have that permanent relief. You have to cut this cord. It's a karmic cord, needs to be cut this month. When it comes to your love, you've got the Ace of Pentacles. Somebody wants to extend an offer. Somebody wants you to be able to accept their apology, you or them. This is a pentacle, so this is a Virgo, Capricorn, or a Taurus here with that. This could also be an offer when it comes to that as well. Now, you are focused on children and dating and fun all of this month, so some of this could be to do with dating. Look, somebody's there, you know, suffering in silence. This could be a game play. I feel like there's got something to do with I'm going to say no when I really want to say yes. I'm withholding love. I'm withholding time. I'm trying to play this game because I'm unable to say how I feel without being vulnerable because of pain that I've had in the past, you or them. I think that this month there is going to be a shift and a big change in that, and you'll be able to move forward. Doreen Virtue, messages from the angels, Cancer, is some of you are depending on others, and there is a change in your home definitely coming. The other in your life, maybe it's about pinning them down, maybe it's about changing the rules and boundaries when it comes to that. Some of you, it is about getting a mortgage for your home and getting on track to do with that. Lot of cards. Okay, so your desired outcome will happen in the very near future. Don't force it. It's going to happen. Akasha says, trust the feelings, the gut that you have there. And be open to exploring the idea of, you know, the universe is looking after me. Have the faith and pushing forward. You've asked the angels for help, and now let them give it to you. Again, this is a mind card. Seizures, migraines, headaches, too many thoughts, anxiety, stress, depression. Got to have the mind to be flat. Look, if you can't afford to have hypnosis with me, do use the link below with the free hypnosis. We need to flatten, silence the mind completely blank for us to be able to recharge, even if it's only for 5 minutes. They're all free. Use it below, but do book in if you can afford it. This is about partnerships and between you and another, and getting that commitment and having that agreement and being on the same page. For some of you, this is about children. We've got the children card here as well, and we're focused on the fifth house all month. Shanti, this is the exact same card as this one. It's sitting in your house. So if this is about fertility and the cycle that we're going on for that, there might be a procedure. There might be some changes there. For some of you, there might be a scare there where you are laid up. So be kind to you and those you love. And from Jedi side, Jake, may the force be with you.